Welcome to the Laravel Collections Guide. In this series, we take a look at each of the available methods in the Laravel Collection class and dive deep through examples in explaining what it does. Today, we're going to be taking a look at whereIn and whereInStrict, two similar methods, but with a slight difference that I will show you today. So let's dive into our first example. I'm going to return collect, and inside the array, we're going to have some products. Let's say product. Our first product is going to be apples. Now let's have a price for each. We'll say 50. Our next product is going to be pears. Next product is going to be bananas. And finally, we'll have coconuts. So we have 50. Let's have 60 price for pears, 70 on bananas, and 80 in coconuts. So now let's call the whereIn method. So the whereIn method will allow you to pass in an array of items that you would want to match. This works a lot like the whereIn statement in SQL queries. So we're going to pass in an array of values, and it's going to try to match up those values. It is very useful when you're trying to match things like ID. In our case, we're going to be matching up some prices. So let's say that price, and then as a second argument, we're going to pass in an array. And I want everything that's $50 and everything that's $70. And it looks like I made a small typo here of 79. I actually meant to type 70. Let's check out the results. And sure enough, we get apples and bananas back. That makes total sense. If we wanted to add coconuts, we'll add 80 to that. And sure enough, we get those three. Now, whereIn has a counter method, and it's whereInStrict. So let's check out what happens when we switch over to whereInStrict. We get an empty array. Now, the difference between whereIn and whereInStrict is that whereInStrict is doing a triple equal check. And when it gets to 50, it gets an integer. However, we wrap this in single quotes, which makes that a string. When we're looking at strict comparisons, a string does not equal an integer. Now, as long as we use whereIn, we are matching everything. Let's check that one more time. However, if we switch over to strict, as the name would suggest, we're getting a little bit more strict, so nothing matches. Now, an easy fix for this would be for us to actually put this in quotes, 50, 70, and 80, all in quotes. And sure enough, we're back to where we started. Now, one final thing I want to tell you about whereIn and whereInStrict is that it returns a new collection. So if we were to save this to a variable, say collection, and then on that new variable, we called the whereInStrict, and then at the end, returned collection, let's see what happens. We get back the original collection. That is because whereIn and whereInStrict is not modifying the original collection, but rather it's creating a whole new collection and returning that. If you needed to save that results, you can save that to a new variable. We'll say new collection equals collection, and we'll return new collection. And let's check out the results. And we're back to where we started. So keep that in mind whenever you're using whereIn and whereInStrict.